all a question of imagination. If we imagine today what kind of world we want, and that's the world we created. If we do not imagine, it will not be done.
When I began, it was one man's crazy dream.
It really did start as just seeing a need and just diving into it.
Doing stuff that people either say can't be done, or why bother, or so what?
To say, okay, let's define the problem and solve it.
To go against the grain, to fight through the challenges and the naysayers.
I have to be stubborn.
It's neither pragmatism nor inspiration that drives me. It's more the passion.
Addressing it kind of one person or one village at a time was not going to be enough.
For us, that means doing all sorts of crazy stuff and just being really fearless about it.
We all have to push through our strengths to help it happen.
It will be a long road.
It's a tough job, but we get so much kick out of it.
We will win this battle.
I know when the work I do is working. By seeing, I know it works.
Margaret Burroughs, for whom the Museum of African American History is named in the city of Chicago. Dr. Burroughs, in her awesome poem, "What Shall I Tell My Children Who Are Black?" she puts it this way, quote, "I have drawn deep from the fountain of my black culture, sat at the knee of and learned from Mother Africa, discovered the truth of my heritage, the truth so often obscured and omitted. And I find I have much to say to my black children. I will lift up their heads in proud blackness with the story of their fathers and their fathers' fathers. And I shall take them into a way back to the kings and queens who ruled the Nile and measured the stars and discovered the laws of mathematics. I will tell them of a black people on whose backs have been built the wealth of three continents. I will tell my black son this and more, and knowledge of his heritage shall be his weapon and his armor. Tell my children our story. Knowledge of his heritage will make him strong enough to win any battle he may face. And since this story is so often obscured, I must sacrifice to find it for my children. Even as I sacrifice to feed my children, clothe my children, and shelter my children. So this I will do for them. I love them. No one else will do it for me.
And that's the kind of thing that sticks with you. I never felt this black. I'm feeling real black right now. Real black right now. I'm feeling real black right now.
Down in Brad Street, watched my dad get shot in front of me when I was 12. Mom was a crackhead. I locked up at 16, got juvenile life. somehow, through the grace of God, some praying grandmothers, Miss Ferris, Miss Coretta King, Naomi King, whole bunch of mamas, I got the ability to go to college.
Speech pouring in this morning in Atlanta, an incredibly emotional scene inside of the Reverend Martin Luther King's old church. Inside of Ebenezer Baptist Church, King's surviving children, Martin and Bernice, were there, and so was his only remaining sibling, Christine Ferris. Another 1,000 people.
Yes, don't ever forget to tell them that, but tell them also about Shifra and Pua, two Egyptian midwives who disobeyed the presidential kill list order, who went against the law, not the law of mass incarceration, but the law of male annihilation. Two Egyptian midwives who refused to take the lives of black boys, but who chose to preserve the lives of black boys. Don't ever forget that part of your story. We need to hear those instructions and heed that advice, or we too will end up like the people of Sumer, described in the opening pages of Chancellor Williams' classic work, The Destruction of Black Civilization. Williams writes, paraphrase, that a traveler in Africa encountered a wise old Rio and asked him one day, whatever happened to the people of Sumer? Legend has it that they were black. Whatever happened to them? Wise old man thought for a moment and then said, they forgot their story.
My mind.
And so they died. Any people who forget their story are dead people. They cease to exist in the minds and the memories of the histories of future generations. They forgot their story. And so they died. Tell your children their story. We need to, first of all, tell our children our story and stop letting other folks tell our children. Start in slavery. Dr. Bobby Wright, one of the founders of the Association of Black Psychologists, said many, many years ago, if you keep starting your story in 1619 in slavery,
My
you
mind.
You will forever have a slave mentality.
My mind.
Our story does not start in slavery. Our story starts in Africa. Our story starts with the cradle of civilization. Children about our slave experience, our story. We need to tell our children about the folks who enslaved us, our children. We need to tell our children about the Africans who sold us, like Joseph's brother sold him in Ghana, in Benin, in Nigeria, in Senegal, in Cote d'Ivoire, and in Angola. We need to tell our children about the Europeans who bought us and brought us across the Atlantic into the British colonies and the European colonies. The European colonies, the Spanish colonies, Cuba, Ecuador, European colonies, the French colonies of Saint Domingue, Martinique, Saint Martin, and Haiti. Please don't ever forget to tell your children about Haiti, we call it Haiti. Tell them about Bookmark and Dessalines. The European colonies, the Dutch colonies of St. Croix and Aruba, the Portuguese colonies of Salvador, Bahia, the home and birthplace of Candomblé and Palmares, the home of Zumbi and the largest quinoa in the Black Atlantic, and tell them about the British colonies of Bahamas, Jamaica, Trinidad, Tobago, St. Thomas, Turks and Caicos, New York, New Jersey, Delaware. Our story does not start in slavery, A. Our story has a 244-year chapter of slavery, yes, B. But our story, like the biblical story, does not end in slavery.